Scott Road I looked at one time. Pretty nice house on it. I think it had 5 or 6 acres. Had a swimming pool and a little barn. I was kind of interested in buying that place. But I ended up buying a ranch in Missouri.
It's nice out there, but it's not as quiet as here anymore. It's getting busier.
Well, Temecula, shit, Murrieta. Turned into big cities.
Temecula and Murrieta have pretty much grown out. They don't have much more room to develop, so they're all building out in Menifee where we are now. They say Menifee will be have more population than Temecula and Murrieta combined.
Wow.
Murrieta's 48 square miles, and it's mostly all buildable land.
Murrieta was a little one-horse town, man, when I grew up.
Yeah. So,
in fact, you'd see people riding horses downtown, going to have breakfast and stuff, tie them up outside.
Yeah. Old Town Murrieta and Temecula, yeah. Not so much anymore, but yeah.
They had a cafe in Murrieta called the Windmill. All the cowboys used to have breakfast there. Probably.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I mean, Temecula was an old cowboy Indian town, but now it's all kind of like, it's all modern to be made to look that way, but it's not really that way anymore, yeah.
Just historical now.
Yeah.
Temecula, you know, I guess in this book I was reading about the history of Temecula, it said they used to have a railroad through Temecula.
Uh-huh.
It must have been way back in the 1800s or something. I don't remember no railroad.
Yeah. I know they had an old wooden road between like San Diego and I think Phoenix. And like a railroad back a long time ago.
Remember, I used to hate going through Phoenix. You'd have to zigzag and take a dozen detours. And all that shit. I was sure glad when they built that freeway going through. Didn't have to take all the detours. I used to haul stuff out of Texas. Horse trailers and goats and everything else.
There you go, you guys are getting in sync now.
She might want to try that other horse in the barn too while she's here. He's a pretty horse, he's got 4 white feet.
Yeah.
White blaze.
Yeah.
And his color changes in the summer when...
Do you get darker or lighter?
Oh, he gets a little darker and he gets slicker and
he loses that winter coat.
He's a pretty horse. He's got that rough winter coat, but it'll go away in a month or so.
Yeah.
You know, if she put a blanket on him, it'd go away quick too.
Yeah, our golden retrievers kind of do the opposite. They get lighter in the summer, a little darker in the winter, I think. Mm-hmm.
Went to the D8 hospital in, I guess it was Menifee.
Uh-huh.
They said it was Murrieta. I don't know.
Loma Linda?
It might have been Menifee.
Loma Linda is technically Murrieta, but it borders right on Menifee.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, I was supposed to see a doctor, and all he did was talk to me on a stupid video camera on a television.
That's not right.
This, you know. Doctor from Loma Linda goes, yeah, Dave, he goes, just come down to Loma Linda next month. Oh, shit. I could have done that over the phone, you know?
Yeah. I don't know. Congress votes themselves raises every 2 years. They work 7 months out of the year.
Yeah, I wish I had a job like that.
Yeah. And then even with all this abortion stuff, they're like, they're getting $100,000 a baby for all the parts and stuff. It's just,
oh God.
The world's gone mad.
Gone nuts. That's why I like to live out in the boondocks, you know.
Yeah.
It's a pain sometimes you get to drive so far to buy groceries or,
right,
you know, buy anything. But you know what? All things considered, it's worth it.
Yeah, that's what I told Sandy. I was like, if we lived out here, it's like, you just have to schedule everything on one day, like on a Wednesday or something,
yeah,
down in Temecula.
Do
everything in one day
I mean,
and spend the other six up here.
I would forget it anyway. I got to make a long list.
Yeah.
You know, otherwise, I can't be going back and forth into town every day, that's for sure. Spend enough money on diesel fuel as it is. She could have him going in a nice gate in no time.
Mm-hmm. He's dropping his head, starting to stretch out.
Yeah. Because I know when I first made him like run a little bit yesterday just to see if he'd do it.
Yeah.
He's like too chargy, you know. He needs
yeah.
to slow down, relax a little bit. Just drop his head, collect himself.
Yeah.
But I think he can run that quick.
Yeah, it's like you said, you let them just kind of hang out and sit around too long, they start kind of thinking they're wild again.
Mm-hmm.